Now, I want to make the point that there are different types of tools that you can use in your toolbox. We just saw the count calls. I think I would classify that as a debugging tool. And we saw a memo, and I'll classify that as a performance tool. And earlier, we saw NARY, another decorator, which I can classify as an expressiveness tool. It gives you more power to say more about your language. This gives you no more power, but makes it faster. This isn't going to end up in your final program, but helps you develop the program faster. And I want to add another tool here in debugging called Trace, which can help you see the execution of your program. So I'm going to define a decorator trace, which when we apply to Fib, gives us this kind of output. When I ask what's the sixth Fibonacci number, it says for each recursive call, we have an indented call with an arrow going to the right saying we're making a call. And for each return, we have an arrow going to the left. When you ask for fib of 6, we keep on going down the list until we get near the end. When we ask for fib of 2, then that's defined in terms of 1 and 0, and they both return 1, so that means fib of 2 returns 2, and so on. And we can see sort of the shape of the trace here as we go. It's coming to the right and then returning back and coming to the right some more and returning back. The pattern takes a long time to reveal itself and would take even longer for larger arguments other than 6. But it gives you some idea for the flow of control of the program. So that's a useful tool to have. And here's an implementation. Follows the same pattern as usual. Decorator takes a function as input. We're going to create another function. And this is what it's going to look like. We're going to figure out what it is that we're going to print. We're going to keep a variable which we keep as an attribute of the trace function itself called the level, and we'll increment that as we come in, print out some results. Here we initialize the trace level to 0, the indentation level, and then finally we return the function that we just built up. And I've left out some bits here, and I want you to fill them in to make this function work properly to show the trace that I just showed.